The concepts of payment, money, currency, and coins all overlap. And as societies, we're transitioning beyond bartered trade to payments with money. What really defined the shift to currency? Let's say this: money is value or an abstraction of value. Currency is the unit of measure. China has been an early adopter of new forms of currency, from squares of deerskin to today's digital yuan. Metal worked well for currency because the metal itself has worth. But metal is also heavy to carry around. Paper money began as a representation of those metal coins. The first banknote for European coins was issued in Canada. In 1685, the colonial governors issued cash to use in place of French coins. In 1816, England set gold as the standard value for backing paper money, and the United States followed, but with the devaluation of gold during the Depression, the US first dropped the gold standard in 1933. After World War II, it was partially reinstituted, and it wasn't until 1973 that the US dollar became a free-floating fiat currency. The worth of a fiat currency depends on the international exchange market. A central bank of an issuing country may intervene through economic policy to manage the value of its currency. Essentially, our faith in a government is what backs fiat currencies. With the arrival of Bitcoin in 2009, cryptocurrencies challenged the idea that currency must be sovereign. And instead of just representing money electronically, through, say, a credit card payment, crypto created the currency itself out of technology. Here at Stronghold, we issued the SHX token as a digital currency within our payments ecosystem. We put it to real-world use in our rewards program, and it also enables us to build virtual payment networks customized for specific purposes. We've come to the end of this video, but the history of currency will continue far into the future as new possibilities for money, coins, and currency emerge.